One of the projects that I've spent the most time on in the recent years is the Oregon Health Insurance Experiment, where we had the opportunity to evaluate the multifaceted effects of Medicaid using a randomized controlled trial, which is almost never available in public policy. But Oregon had a lottery for a limited number of Medicaid slots, and they drew names from a waiting list. The people whose names were drawn got Medicaid, and the people whose names weren't drawn didn't get Medicaid. So we were able to use that to figure out what exactly this major health insurance program does. And we found some things that supported people who were in favor of expanding Medicaid and some things that supported people who were not in favor of expanding Medicaid. And it was really interesting to see how that played out in the public policy sphere. We could eliminate the really unduly optimistic view of Medicaid. Some people thought Medicaid was such a wonderful program that it would expand health care and improve health for low-income populations, get them out of the emergency department, back in the workforce, and actually save money. It turns out Medicaid doesn't save money. When you expand health insurance, people do use more health care, and that's great for their health, but it doesn't save the government money. We could also eliminate the unduly pessimistic view of the program, that Medicaid was a terrible program that didn't get people access to health care, that didn't improve their health at all. In fact, people who got Medicaid had much better access to care, had much reduced financial strain, they didn't have bills sent to collections, they weren't turned away from providers because of bills they hadn't paid, their depression dropped by about 30%, they used more preventive care, their self-reported health was better, they didn't have a lot of improvement in things like blood pressure or diabetes, so it was a little bit of a mixed bag on the health side, but they were definitely much better off than if they were uninsured. Well, that's a tough problem for policymakers, and that gets back to having a good analytical toolkit. It would be easy to decide about a program like Medicaid if it was all upside, if people were better off and it didn't cost any money, or if it was all downside, if people were not any better off and it was expensive. But of course, like most policies, it has some winners and some losers, and having a really rigorous way to think through what that means policymakers should do, that's the mission of schools of public policy.